A former member of the Pussycat Dolls, Kaya Jones, recently tweeted out that every single Democrat that voted against the Born Alive bill received money from Planned Parenthood. So we were wondering, is this true? First of all, what is the Born Alive bill? Well, its full title is the Born Alive Abortion Survivors Protection Act, a bill put forward by Senator Ben Sasse of Nebraska in January, and it aimed to prohibit a healthcare practitioner, in other words a doctor, from failing to exercise the proper degree of care in the case of a child who survives an abortion or an attempted abortion.
The bill's terms are simple. A child born alive during a botched abortion would be given the same level of care that would be provided to any other baby born at that same gestational stage. That's it.
Basically, if a baby were born alive after an attempted abortion, the doctor would be required by law to do everything in his or her power to save the infant. In February, this went to the Senate floor for a vote and received only 53 of the 60 votes needed to proceed.
A bill designed to protect newborns against infanticide defeated on the Senate floor last night.
The Senate voted Monday to reject a so-called Born Alive bill.
On Capitol Hill, a defeat for a pro-life bill on the Senate floor.
50 of the votes were from Republicans and 3 from Democrats, along with 42 nays from Democrats and 2 independents. 3 senators were absent from voting for various reasons, but even if they had voted in favor of the bill, it still wouldn't have been enough to clear the 60-vote hurdle. So does Kaya Jones' claim that all the Democrats who voted nay for the Born Alive bill received donations from Planned Parenthood hold up? Yes, it does. According to the Federal Election Commission, the Planned Parenthood Action Fund donated to 41 of the senators' primary campaign committees and to 1 joint fundraising committee for Maria Cantwell in their most recent election cycle. Democrats say that they're opposed to the bill because they felt that it was another attack on a woman's right to choose.
This is just the latest step in the far right's long march to strip away women's rights. A march whose pace has now quickened under our current president.
I want to ask each and every one of my colleagues whether or not we're okay with infanticide.
Republicans, for their part, want to put Democrats on the record, and they're hoping to bring this to the House floor next. But with a Democrat-controlled House, this is going to be an uphill battle.
But this bill is not actually about anything that limits abortion. This bill doesn't have anything to do with Roe v. Wade. This bill's about something else. What this bill does is try to secure basic rights, equal rights, for babies that are born and are outside the womb. That's what we're talking about.
I've said this 1,000 times before, and I'll keep saying it until I go hoarse. A woman's medical decisions should be between her and her physician and her family, and not dictated by some politician in Washington, D.C.
So as with any polarizing issue, always be sure to check your facts. If you want to learn more about Check Your Fact, follow us on Facebook and subscribe so you can stay up to date on our latest fact checks.